different mothers, mothers of the home, matron of the home, left lady, all my brothers and sisters, better good morning. So the task givers and they that would come and visit and support you, I must say a pleasant good morning. This morning, God is good.
Amen.
And His mercy is
correct.
Am I talking to God, people? God is good.
Yes.
And His mercy is
correct.
We'll try it one more time. Mommy, God is
good.
And His mercy is
correct.
Give God a round of applause. I really, really intend to come to preach this morning, amen, but because I just come to worship and learn Thanksgiving, amen?
Amen.
But up here inviting me to Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And as I was telling the guys why we just know, if you're still dry, then something wrong, amen?
Amen.
Nothing wrong with Thanksgiving, no? Something wrong with?
You.
Yes, when you leave home with the intention to come and do whatever you intend to do.
Yes.
If you leave home to worship, it don't have nobody that born yet and the mother died that will stop you from worshiping.
Amen.
Remember that here. When I leave home to come up here in Thanksgiving, the person that could stop me ain't born yet.
Amen.
And the mother passed away. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
If I have to shout alone, I will shout alone. Why? Because I know what God has done for me. When God has done great things in your life, people cannot understand the overwhelming feeling that is inside of you. But there must come a time when you worship and people don't understand what you're doing.
Yes.
When you begin to climb inside a realm with God, you begin to climb out of reality and into the matrix. That matrix don't have a Morpheus. Hallelujah. Praise God. So God is good and His mercy is enduring forever. I will not know. All I come to tell you is be consistent.
That's right.
Amen. The scripture spoke about just as you receive Christ. You see that word so? If you know how important that little two-letter word is in reference to this text.
Yeah.
Most people interpret it as to say, you receive Christ, so walk in Him. But there are many ways that you can walk in Christ. And it might sound kind of strange. But the Bible says somewhere in Acts that there were some people that was calling on the name of Jesus. So once some demons that was in a man, and the demons said, Paul, I know.
Uh-huh.
Peter, I know. And Jesus, I know too, but who?
Go on.
So here the very difference now. As you have received Christ, so walk in Him. Meaning, just how you get it, keep it that way, and don't let nobody change it from being just how you get it. Sometimes in the ministry and sometimes in the Christian walk, we receive Christ and we walk in a particular way. We get a particular type of teaching for baptism class. We get a different type of teaching when we start over in church. But somewhere along the line, as we go upon life's journey, some changes does come in. Like what Paul was talking about. So Paul came to remind some people. Not to give them any new news, but he comes to remind them that just as you start, the same ambition, the same zeal, and the same teachings that you would have received when you start, is so I want you to continue, because here the Bible says, we are not made partakers of Christ if we don't hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast unto the end. I'll say that again. We are made partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast unto the end.
Yeah.
So it means to say it's not how good you start. It's not how glorious you start. It's not how good your record was. It's good when you start like that. Now come on. Most people when they now start every day, they sing gospel. They now watching no action movies, they don't obscene language. Well, let them act like they don't know what I'm talking about. But we now start. If you be radio always on 107.1. 98.1 the promise. We don't listen to boom champions. No. We don't listen to the beginning and the second. No. But we don't start. We don't forget them channel. We forget all the movie channels. We sometimes don't know we don't even watch no cartoon. All you want to watch is Jesus of Nazareth. Passion of Christ. And the Ten Commandments. Nothing no wrong with that. I'm happy for you. I wasn't so sure. I'm happy. But the difference is when the beginning resembles the ending. That's what Christ is looking for. So everything you have to come at the beginning of the journey, I hope it didn't lose now.
Glory.
Amen. I got time. You ever say, as a little key I give you, everything you pick up at the beginning, I hope it didn't lose it.
That's right. Nice.
So I will expand the word a little bit for you, because the thing about God's word is God's word like corn. So I'll expand it for you. If you hold the beginning of your marriage, step fast unto the end. That's the only time you'll be able to stand and say, I have been married X amount of years and God has kept us. Together, give God a round of applause. What we're doing this morning is consistency, and as long as you remain consistent in Christ, everything will be alright. Let me tell you something. Since I start coming here, I know it. Praise God. I meet all of you, they're more senior than me, amen? And I want to say that everything that I saw when I just came,
it's Lord.
The same thing. Praise God. I think I remember you always had them two ring too. Praise the Lord. How I meet you at the start is exactly how you continue to. And I hear some years, so I know you hear more than me. Praise God. And I want you to continue.
That's right.
And I will say this to you as well. So walk in Him. Hear this. You know, I must be always something every time I come, right? When I was young and I was a teenager, I never knew my brother. I never see him in my life. And I got his number, and I called him, and I tried to link up with him. And he came, but I didn't tell him which house. I said, when you reach the street, call me, and I'll come out. And I was putting out some garbage outside or something, and I saw this car drive down, and the car pull up and stop it, park up and switch off, and the man come right up to the door. He knocked. And he said, "Could you inside there?" I said, "Yeah." So I asked him something, "How do you know that is this house to come?" He said, "Well, I see you on your outside." "Yeah." "You sleep very low." I said, "How do you know the person you saw was your brother?" "Because it had plenty of people on the side of the street." And hear what he said, and this is what I'm going to put. There's no word to you. He said, "Just how you walk, I remember my father."
That's right. Go on. Nice point. Go on. Yes.
He said, "When I watch how you walk, even though you is the outside child, you just walk more like your father than me and my other brothers than them."
Yes.
It means to say that when you belong to a bloodline,
yes,
when you belong to a bloodline, just in your very walk, you just give it away. The way you talk, just give it away. People can't help but notice that you're walking like your father.
Amen. Amen. Nice.
Point to everybody, amen? I belong to the military. I will be able to notice anybody who walking here that belong to the military too. You understand what I'm saying? The way how you walk and you carry about yourself does give away where you belong, especially if it's somebody that belongs to the same bloodline as you. God bless.
Glory to God, amen.